Hari Ame! It was Judgment Day in Aggie Land, and tenseness filled the air. All knew there was a trip at hand, but not a soul knew where. Assembled on the drill field was the world-renowned 12th man, the entire Fightin' Aggie team, and the famous Aggie Band. And out in front, with royal guard, the reviewing party stood. St. Peter and his angel staff were choosing bad from good. First, he surveyed the Aggie team, and in terms of an angel swore, "By Jove, I do believe I've seen this gallant group before. I've seen them play since way back when, and they've always had the grit. I've seen them lose, and I've seen them win, but I've never seen them quit." But I have never seen them quit. No need to tarry here, deciding upon their fates. 'Tis plain as the halo on my head that they've opened heaven's gates. And when the 12th man heard this, they let out a mighty yell that echoed clear to heaven and shook the gates of hell. "And who is this upon the side?" St. Peter asked his aide. "That swelled with pride when we our judgment bade." "Why, sir, that's the cadet corps that's known but far and wide for backing up their fighting team, whether they won, lost, or tied." "Well then," said St. Peter, "it's very plain to me that within the realms of heaven, they should spend eternity. And have the Texas Aggie Band at once commence to play. For their fates too, we must decide upon this crucial day." And the drum major, so hearing, slowly raised his hand and said, "Boys, let's play the spirit for the last time in Aggie Land." And the band poured forth the anthem in notes both bright and clear, and 10,000 Aggie voices sang the song they hold so dear. And when the band had finished, St. Peter wiped his eyes and he said, "It's not so hard to see they're meant for paradise." And the colonel of the cadet corps said, as he stiffly took his stand, "It's just another corps trip, boys. We'll march in behind the band." Howdy, Army! I can't believe that we're here tonight. Our last midnight yell practice, well, I guess 7 p.m. yell practice of the season, and the last one for us seniors for this season and ever. It's crazy to say, but I feel old. Feels like I was just a junior out there doing push-ups and pacing on the 50-yard line. But as I look back over these past 2 years, I thank God. I am beyond happy and grateful for the things that I got to see and do. The 12th man has done some incredible things while I was a yell leader. And I am very grateful that I got to contribute to them as a junior and head yell leader. It's been an honor. I am damn proud of the 12th man and very lucky to say that I've been a part of it. We beat number one Alabama right here in Kyle Field. We broke the Reed Arena attendance record last year. And we had three full decks for both of our opening midnight yell practices. So thank you, 12th man, for allowing me to serve y'all as a yell leader for the past 2 years and making them two of the greatest years of my life. I will never forget them. And thank you, Mom and Dad, for always being there for me and never missing a single midnight yell practice. And thank you, Julie, for being the best big sister that a little brother could ever ask for, and for always being somebody I can look up to. Thank you, Concetta, for being by my side for these past 2 years, through everything, all the highs and the lows. She also never missed a single midnight yell practice. And thank you, Dr. D, for being the best advisor that us yell boys could ever ask for. I love every single one of y'all. And finally, thank you to the four gentlemen standing behind me. I learned a great deal from them this past year, and I'm beyond grateful for it. And I'm going to be selfish and say that we're the best group to ever do it. I love y'all. Now, being a yell leader has been a great experience, and it always will be. But I can guarantee that these four guys right here will go on and do even greater things with their lives. And hopefully I will too. Now, for my final words, I want to encourage every single one of y'all to give everything that you have to Texas A&M. We are very lucky to call ourselves Aggies. This is the most exclusive club in the entire world. And it's one where everyone is equal. It doesn't matter who you are or where you came from. You're an Aggie. That's what matters. This is a truly special place. There's a spirit here that only Aggies can understand. And the people behind that spirit is us, the 12th man. So carry it on. Go to the football game when it's 39 degrees and it's pouring rain. Go with your buddies and your friends out to the ticket pool line at 12 a.m. the night before. And take all your friends to a midnight yell practice on Friday. And take a break from studying at 10 p.m. on a Tuesday so you can go to Silver Taps. And go to muster and softly call here to honor all the Aggies that have come before us. Our traditions are what make us Aggies. So cherish them and carry them on. And I can guarantee you that if you do that, you will look back and be proud of your time as a part of the 12th man, just like I'm doing right now. Now, let's end this season on a high note. Let's go out there tomorrow And let's go ruin LSU's playoff hopes. Now let's have a fun Texas A&M practice.
Howdy! Before we get into all the serious stuff, I just want to do this one more time. Why did LSU change their field from grass to artificial turf? To keep their cheerleaders from grazing on the field at halftime. Man, that'll never get old. First, to start off, I'd just like to thank my family to my dad, who I've looked up to my whole life, to my sister, who fell in love with A&M 4 years before I even applied here, and to my mom, who shows me every day that you don't need to have gone to school here to be an Aggie. Thank y'all for the love and support, the care packages, the phone calls, and everything else the last 4 years. I'll be forever grateful. I'd also like to thank my girlfriend, Jen, the past 2+ years of running around, dates at basketball games, because that's the only time I could see you, bannering just to get us elected, and now 21 midnight yell practices together. Getting to share this experience has truly been something special. So thank you. Lastly, I'd like to thank my buddies in Squadron 3, my roommate Peyton, and these four guys right here. Y'all have seriously become some of my best friends, and there's nobody else that I'd rather share this past 4 years with. So thank y'all. I'd also like to thank Dr. D. Man, the past 2 years have been a blast. Dr. D, thank you for fulfilling any role, from being our advisor to being our mom at away games, and more importantly, just being our friend. I'll be forever grateful. Before I give up the mic here forever, I'd just like to say some final thoughts. A&M is truly a special place. You know, 5 years ago, I had no idea where I wanted to go to school. But it's been incredible to me how trusting in God's sovereignty and His plan has led to so many blessings and opportunities. There's truly no place like Aggieland. I've gotten to go to a lot of schools across the nation in the past 2 years, and I've never seen anything like the 12th man. We are so blessed and so lucky to go to school here, whether it's 100,000 people at tomorrow's game, the most red-ass 10,000 people here tonight, or any other tradition on campus. The people are what makes A&M special. I encourage y'all to continue to show up to our traditions. Encourage others to do the same, because that's the special part about A&M. That's the intangible part of the Aggie spirit that everybody talks about. A common people in a common place with a common passion. And that's Texas A&M. My last piece of advice would just be to always know that your position, your uniform, or the organization that you're in don't define you. What defines you is your actions, how you make others feel, and the relationships that you build here. Guys, seriously, thank y'all for the opportunity to lead the 12th man this past 2 years. It's been the blessing of a lifetime. Thanks, Giggum, and Ags by 90 tomorrow.
trying to say thank you to Texas A&M and the 12th man will forever be one of the biggest understatements of my entire life. I first of all want to say a couple thank yous. Thank you to the Corps Cadets and to Squadron 17 for taking this long-haired high school senior, giving him a buzz cut, teaching him some damn manners, and teaching him what it means to be a Fightin' Texas Aggie. Next, I want to thank my family, my mom, dad, and brother, for raising me with a wardrobe full of Aggie clothes. Everything, and I mean everything that I've earned at Texas A&M, I owe to y'all, and I love you. Whoop! And, mom and dad, I will say, putting my middle name as Kyle for Kyle Field ended up aging pretty well. Next, I need to thank my roommate of 4 years, Matthew Chang. Matthew, I want you to know that you've been the best example for not only what a good Aggie looks like, but for a godly man looks like. And I love you too. Next, I'd like to thank these guys behind me. Zach, Kip, Trevor, and Thomas. Y'all need to know that I'm so grateful for every single one of y'all, and thank you for believing in me. And lastly, I want to thank you, the 12th man. And I've said it once, and I'll say it again, y'all made my dream come true. I was just a little boy who dreamed of coming to Texas A&M, got on blend team, got here, joined the Corps, got elected as a senior yell leader, and I can't thank you enough. And you have to know, the only way that I can articulate it is I feel like I'm dreaming with my eyes open. So thank you. Now, I know that Midnight Yell outside of Texas A&M is not the most popular thing. So regarding some of those earlier Midnight Yells in the year, I'd like to take this time to apologize to absolutely nobody. If you don't like Texas A&M's traditions, I got news for you. Highway 6 runs both ways, and I heard that TU is gladly accepting. The reputation of Texas A&M doesn't come from nothing. It comes from the thousands of Aggies that were before you, and now it's our job to uphold those traditions and that spirit every single day. So I challenge you. I challenge each and every single one of you to make it a personal mission to do that every single day. Say howdy to people. Go to Midnight Yell. Go to Silver Taps. Go to Muster. Kiss somebody at Mug Down. And you know what? Go to Fightin' Texas Aggie Midnight Yell at 7 p.m. But before all else, I want everyone to remember that the spirit of Aggieland doesn't reside in Texas A&M's campus. It's not in Kyle Field. It's not in the Quad. It's not in Heldenfels. It's in every single one of your heart, and it's in the love and the passion that we share with every single one of us. So thanks, dig 'em. God bless Texas A&M, and let's beat the hell out of LSU. Howdy, Army! Real quick, tomorrow is maroon out, so everybody go check out their Instagram posts and figure out what shirt you need to wear to stripe the tans. All right, and now, finally, I want to say thank you to every single person that came out here tonight. It means so much to us seniors, you wouldn't believe it. We love you, 12th man, and we will always be grateful for y'all. Now, I know 7 p.m. midnight y'all practice didn't happen as late as we wanted it to, but hey, now you got your evenings, you can go to bed early, probably not, you'll probably go to Northgate. But no matter what, have fun tonight, be safe, and get lots of rest, because we got one more game tomorrow, and we'll be seeing y'all at 6 p.m. sharp. Thanks, gig 'em, and God bless Texas A&M.